Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's Red Dead Redemption 2 video, we're going to be finding out who is really inside of Josiah Trelawney's secret Saint Denis house. So this is something I covered a couple of months ago, actually, that if you're in Chapter 4 when the gang actually moves to Shady Bell, which is that like big mansion in the swamp, Josiah Trelawney at times is not with you. Now, he floats in and out of the gang quite a bit, and you can actually discover that he has a secret home or apartment, I guess you would call it, in Saint Denis. And what's even more interesting is you can actually come across Josiah Trelawney's house and you can listen in on a conversation that he is having with his family. And it's definitely kind of interesting. So take a listen to this. It does give some nice backstory on Josiah Trelawney and sort of his family life and situation.
That was absolutely delicious, my dear. Thank you. Well, I think a toast is in order, don't you? Here, let's fill that water glass, Tarkin. It's unlucky to cheers on an empty glass. Okay. To the Trelawneys. It's good to be home.
The Trelawneys! Are you staying now, Daddy?
I wish I could, my boy. I really do. But business calls. Oh, I almost forgot. I don't suppose anybody here would be interested in, say, present?
Me!
Okay, this is for you.
Wow, thanks!
And this one's for you, Cornelius.
A spinning top!
I got that in a town called Blackwater. And last but not least, for you, my dear.
Aw, thank you.
Now run along and play, boys. Let your mother and I read the newspapers.
Trelawney?
Arthur? What on earth are you doing here? I can't speak now. Sorry. Can we catch up in the office on Monday? Let's adjourn to the parlor, my dear. Not a moment's peace.
So this conversation actually revealed a lot. Not only is Josiah Trelawney secretly a family man, he has a wife and two sons. One of them is named Tarquin and another is named Cornelius. And he seems to not want to be associated with the gang and Arthur, as he totally lies about his work. He says he'll like meet Arthur in the office, which clearly is not going to happen. And it's just an awkward conversation, and that's the end of it right there. Now, after that happens, Josiah Trelawney will actually come up to you in camp, and you'll have another sort of awkward encounter as he tries to explain what happened.
I know you saw me in town with my wife.
I never knew you were married.
It's hard, Arthur. I love her, but I can't stand still. Can't do it.
Poor woman.
Oh, she's fine. She knows who she married.
Did she?
No, probably not.
So that's what we found out a couple of months ago. However, I was curious to know, A, what's inside of Josiah Trelawney's house, and B, was he and his family actually inside? So that's what we're going to be finding out in this video today. So once again, I returned to where Josiah Trelawney's house is, and I tried to get inside using the regular sort of lantern and pistol combination that we've been using for a lot of other locations in-game. And I wasn't having a lot of success. Now, Josiah Trelawney's apartment looks to be two stories. You have this little outside balcony, and then there's a bottom portion where there's other doors and windows, even though you can't see through them. And I was not having any success trying to get inside of Josiah Trelawney's house. At the very little, I was able to like slightly glitch through, and it didn't seem as if there was any interior. However, I really wasn't satisfied with that discovery, so I wanted to do some more digging and some more investigating to find out what is actually inside of Josiah Trelawney's house. So I started thinking to myself, okay, maybe it would be possible if I tried to get in on the roof or another level. Maybe that would allow me to sneak in a little bit more. So I went around the corner and I got onto the roof, and then I jumped to this balcony, which actually allowed me to jump to Josiah Trelawney's roof. So we're on top of his apartment technically right now. And what I did was I found a wall that I think would have been a little bit easier to get inside. And this is what happened on my first attempt. I was actually able to get inside. However, I fell through the entirety of the map. Now, I was very briefly able to see kind of what was over in Josiah Trelawney's apartment, but I couldn't really see or confirm much. So I was a little bit disappointed in that, so I wanted to try my luck at this again. And this time, I was able to sort of glitch my way through the wall, and this confirmed at least the first part of this mystery today. There is no interior to Josiah Trelawney's house. The only thing you can see is like a little bit of a hallway where the door is, and then where the window is, at least on the second story, there almost seems to be like this empty black room. Now, I'm not too sure why Rockstar did this, because there's no way for us to even look into that room, so that is even a little bit confusing. Maybe they, at some point in time, were going to plan, have Arthur the ability to like peek inside, kind of like how he can do with the Braithwaite secret outhouse, but maybe they cut that, maybe they decided not to add it. And then I jumped down to the first floor of his apartment, and I didn't see anything here either. So Josiah Trelawney's family is not inside, and unfortunately there is no interior, so we don't get to see the lavish lifestyle that someone like Josiah Trelawney might actually be living it up in the city. But once again, I wasn't really satisfied with this because I started thinking, you know, if there's no one in here, where are the voices coming from? I thought that this was just so weird. You know, are they coming from the sky? Are they coming from someone else? You know, someone is simulating Josiah Trelawney's voice and his two sons and his wife. So what the heck? That's kind of strange. So I wanted to do this one more time to see if I could actually get inside there to see anything. Maybe it was a glitch or something like that. And this time when I jumped down, I went in first person and something strange happened. There are four random NPCs in the first floor of Josiah Trelawney's house. So I am no video game designer or programmer by any means, but what I think has happened here is that instead of having Josiah and his wife and his two sons and creating character models for them, what Rockstar did was just use four random NPCs, and they just attached the voice lines to these NPCs for this specific interaction. Because I'm sure no one at Rockstar assumed that we would be able to glitch inside here, so it wouldn't matter who was projecting the voices as long as the voices were there. So that is creepy. Inside of Josiah Trelawney's house are just these four mysterious NPCs. So upon discovering these guys were here, I wanted to try a couple experiments. I actually tried lassoing them. That did not work. And I tried shooting at them, and you cannot kill them. But when you do that, they will start to like walk and run through the walls. And they all eventually ran away, which was kind of weird. Now, when they ran away, I actually went back to Josiah Trelawney's house, and something strange happened. He was talking, but there were like missing lines of dialogue. It was so weird. Take a listen to this.
That was absolutely delicious, my dear. Thank you. Well, I think a toast is in order, don't you? Here, let's fill that water glass, Tarkin. It's unlucky to cheers on an empty glass. Okay. To the Trelawneys. It's good to be home.
Trelawney, is that you in there?
Arthur? What on earth are you doing here? I can't speak now. Sorry. Can we catch up in the office on Monday? Let's adjourn to the parlor, my dear. Not a moment's peace.
So there were lines of dialogue that were supposed to be said there, but because some of the NPCs on the first floor had scattered off, there wasn't any NPC to say the lines. So you just didn't hear anything. Like, his family didn't react to the things that he said. So overall, really strange. Rockstar sort of took the shortcut route to put Josiah Trelawney inside. So unfortunately, we don't get to see what his wife looks like. We don't get to see what his sons are like. We can only hear them. And they are just sort of ghosts in the shell of an NPC, a random one, on the first floor of his empty apartment. But anyways, that's all the information that I've got for you guys in this video today. That right there is who is really inside of Josiah Trelawney's secret San Denis house in Red Dead Redemption 2. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Were you surprised by this, or does this not shock you at all, especially if you have any background in game design or programming or anything like that? Let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more in the comments down below. I'd love to hear from you guys down there. If you did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new, or you like daily Red Dead Redemption 2 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.